Good morning, welcome to St. Mary's. Please stand and join in our opening hymn, number 739. I heard the voice of Jesus say, number 739.
Lay down, O weary one, lay In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Certainly welcome as we gather for Mass today. Today we hear first about the remnant of Israel that God welcomes back and rejoices because of their faithfulness. We hear the blind man approaching Jesus in repentance, wanting to see. So we seek always to see the wonders of God. We prepare for the sacred encounter with the Lord here at Holy Mass by calling to mind our sin. We ask God for forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, shout with joy for Jacob, exalt at the head of the nations, proclaim your praise and say, the Lord has delivered his people, the remnant of Israel. Behold, I will bring them back from the land of the north. I will gather them from the ends of the world, with the blind and the lame in their midst. The mothers and those with child, they shall return as an immense throng. They departed in tears, but I will console them and guide them. I will lead them to brooks of water on a level road so that none shall stumble. For I am a father to Israel. Ephraim is my firstborn. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, every high priest is taken from among men and made their representative before God to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He is able to deal patiently with the ignorant and erring, for he himself is beset by weakness, and so, for this reason, must make sin offerings for himself as well as for the people. No one takes this honor upon himself, but only when called by God, just as Aaron was. In the same way, it was not Christ who glorified himself in becoming high priest, but rather the one who said to him, "You are my son, this day I have begotten you." Just as he says in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. As Jesus was leaving Jericho with his disciples and a sizable crowd, Bartimaeus, a blind man, the son of Timaeus, sat by the roadside begging. On hearing that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, "Jesus, son of David, have pity on me." And many rebuked him, telling him to be silent. But he kept calling out all the more, "Son of David, have pity on me." Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." So they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take courage, get up. Jesus is calling you." He threw aside his cloak and sprang up and came to Jesus. Jesus said to him in reply, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man replied to him, "Master, I want to see." Jesus told him, "Go on your way. Your faith has saved you." Immediately he received his sight and followed him on the way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Christ. Certainly welcome to everyone on this fine, fine Sunday morning. Beautiful colors out. Just gorgeous outside this time of year. As we all come together in unity with Jesus Christ for this 30th Sunday in ordinary time, may we beg our Lord Jesus Christ that we have a vision that brings us to Him. Do we see the beauty in all the beautiful colors of the fall season? Do we recognize where that beauty is coming from? It's not the trees, it's from God. We must see. God has given us the promise of salvation. We must see it to get there. God has given this salvation promise to all of us, no matter what. But are we spiritually blind and we cannot see the way? We have to ask that. In the first reading, we hear about how the prophet Jeremiah gives great hope that no matter whether blind nor lame, God is with you forever if you follow him. We all qualify to follow God and Jesus. We all qualify to go to heaven. We're granted salvation, all of us, no matter what. In the second reading, we hear the message that God, the high priest, has petitioned his son, Jesus Christ, to be the high priest for us, for eternity, forever. He will not pass in death like Melchizedek and Aaron. Jesus will live forever with us and grant us salvation, show us the way. We see Jesus is very comfortable in who we are and wants to bring us to his Father. But we must see our sins and allow God to forgive us. Sometimes that's hard. And in the gospel, it spells out that we must believe God will give us the vision through his son, Jesus Christ. But we must believe. How many of us have cried out to God or Jesus and cried out to him that, why God, where are you at? Why have you let this be done? How many of us have been there? Come to find out, he's right there. He's right there. When we're hurting, sometimes we get spiritually blinded and we can't see. No matter who you are, what you have done, God is showing all of us, the way to salvation. That brings me to a story that I have, and it's about something that's happened to me about 3 years ago, and it's called macular degenerate disease. And it's a vision impairment. About 3 years ago, I found out that I went to the doctor, the eye doctor, and I was feeling kind of, my vision wasn't very good. And he told me, look at the chart, to read the chart. And they covered my right eye. I didn't see nothing. Kind of like sometimes when we're going through life. We're going through life and we think that everything is okay. But we don't realize we're not being spiritually fed and we're not walking toward Jesus. The macular degenerate disease blocks out all the sight in the middle of your eye. And I was way beyond treatment. They tried a little bit, but they gave up really early. And I had troubles adjusting. You know, sometimes when something spiritually happens to you, we don't know where to go and how to fix it. Jesus is right there with us. Here, show us the way. The struggles with seeing bright lights became something really obnoxious. If I was driving down the road and it was dark out and there was a car coming at me with its brights on, I just grabbed a hold of the wheel and just kind of tried to go straight. Hopefully nothing came around because it blinded me. How many people have been blinded by a spiritual light that scared them away, that said, oh, that's too bright? How many people have done that? I know I have. When you're going through spiritual darkness, you don't know it. You don't realize what's happening to you. You don't see it. But one thing I found out with the bright lights is that I like a lighted room a lot. I require much more light. Kind of like when we're spiritually led to Jesus, that you bask in that light. Some of my rooms, we often kid, especially my office room, we often kid that the lights are so bright that it makes a good landing strip for an airplane. But when we walk with Jesus, we get to bask in his glory. We get to bask in the light of Jesus Christ. When we open up both eyes, both hearts, all our hearts, our minds, our soul, we can see what Jesus wants us to see. And it's amazing. The bright lights just bask. And sometimes when you walk in Christ, the light and God will lead your vision right to Christ. Look at the light that you want to see so bad, but cannot, until you look through the heart of Jesus. I found out with this macular degenerative disease that you can't see colors so well either. And sometimes, you know, you see a red, maybe it's orange, maybe it's red. You can't really make out a defining difference sometimes with this. And it kind of reminds me that sometimes we forget to thank God about the beauty of the world. We don't see the beauty of the world. We don't see the good. Sometimes we have to realize and be thankful for the colors and for the greatness and the beauty that God shows us all around us. Spiritual blindness can be a tough thing. And the toughest thing about spiritual blindness is if you don't know you have it, or you refuse to believe you have it, that you're spiritually okay, that you're spiritually in a good place. Are you sure that that road that you are walking is going to lead you to Jesus? And if you have dictated what the way you're going, you better reevaluate immediately, because God needs to show us the way. I can't, as the story goes with my macular degenerative disease, I come into very many trials. A couple weeks ago, I was down hunting, and a deer walked in front of me, and it was about 7:15. It's just getting dark out, about half dark and half light. Well, I pulled my bow up and I tried to look. I couldn't see nothing. I couldn't find nothing. It wasn't there. But when I took the scope away, I could see it. But I couldn't see it well enough. Kind of like our spirituality sometimes, where we can't see it. We don't know how to fix it. And that's look through the heart of Jesus. And then another week later, I was down southern Ohio hunting with a friend, and we both climbed up a tree, and he was filming me, and we were hunting together, and a nice buck come across at about the same time, about 7:15, 7:30, and my buddy's like, he's pointing. It's right underneath me. It's for me to father. This deer is for me to father. And I'm like, oh, crap. And I get the bow up. I couldn't find it. I couldn't see it. Spiritual blindness. I can't find my Jesus. I didn't know where my Jesus was. That's what spiritual blindness is. Not having Jesus in your heart. That's what it is. Well, then this Monday, I went out again hunting. And about same time, why does this keep happening? I thought this big buck come out, and I couldn't very well see it. I couldn't get a scope on it. I tried to get it in the binoculars once again. I can't see it. I can't see it. God's telling us many things that we don't see. God's showing us many things that we don't see. And after that, I was very disappointed. Kind of like we are in life when things don't go our way or somebody dies or something bad in our life happens. I was frustrated. Wondered a little bit maybe why Jesus would put me through this. And thinking about, you just need to quit. Stop. Maybe this is God telling you to stop hunting. Just stop. Well, in prayer, that wasn't the vision that God gave me. God gave me the vision that says, when you're out there, look at the beauty. Look at what I give you. Look at what I'm showing you. Made a whole difference. I went out Wednesday, this Wednesday. About 10 minutes before that haunting time, big old buck come walking out. He should have had a clock because he was about 10 minutes early, and I could see. And although that ended well, but that gives us the complete story that we're going to go through life and bad things are going to happen. And we're going to get going down the wrong road sometimes. And our vision is not going to be with Jesus Christ. The sooner we lock on and lock eyes with Jesus, the sooner we're going to get fixed. And our spirituality is going to lead us into salvation, which is our goal. There is a perfect prescription out there to fix spiritual blindness. It's all the sacraments, but especially the Eucharist. If you want to truly connect with the heart of Jesus and see the vision that he has for you spiritually, the Eucharist will lighten your vision. It will show you the light that brings you in to Him, that shows you the way. All our sacraments, reconciliation, all of them tie in to this spiritual blindness that we have to beware of. That brings me to an event that we have coming on November 9th. It's called Anointed for Mission. Or should I say, Anointed for Vision. An opportune time to come and spiritually ignite your spiritualness and see what Jesus has for us, how we can serve Him. They're going to tell you more about this mission, so I'm not going into detail. But I will say that if you're searching for spirituality and you're searching for Jesus, these events will show you a vision that brings you closer to Christ. We must seek spiritual vision to see salvation. Much of the world is spiritually blind. We must recognize if we are.
We profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead. Amen. Gracious God, Bartimaeus had the courage to ask Jesus for the ability to see. We now offer to You our needs and prayers, trusting that You will give us what we truly need.
For Pope Francis, and especially for Bishop Thomas, as he celebrates the 10th anniversary of installation as the Bishop of Toledo. May all who lead the church be inspired by God as they call us to holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the United States of America, as we approach Election Day, may all of us seek to be informed as we exercise our right to vote, and may those elected to office promote equality and justice for all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, that we may provide a different way of seeing to those who are seeing a deeper sense of meaning. May we guide them on the path to eternal happiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people who are blind or struggle with other disabilities, may they know of our love and receive the assistance they need to ease the burdens they face daily. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God's blessing on our parish Faith Enrichment Day, anointed for mission, may many grow in the understanding of the power of our baptism and our call to honor and serve Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those the Lord is calling to serve as priests in the Diocese of Toledo, may their participation in the Holy Eucharist lead them to offer their lives in service of others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick or suffering in body, mind, or spirit, may they confidently approach Jesus and receive what they need to sustain their life and get to heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Donald Cape, may all the faithful departed be with Jesus in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers written in the Parish Book of Intentions and our personal prayers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious and loving God, you welcome us and offer us what we need to fulfill our deepest desires. We ask that you hear our prayers and grant them according to your will, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 802, Christ Be Our Light, number 802.
Because you're own, you're holy, be
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in number 577, At the Table of the World, number 577.
Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Sandy Birkebile. On behalf of St. Michael's, the amazing parish leadership team, and St. Mary's Christian Formation Committee, I would like to invite you to St. Michael's, St. Mary's, St. Joseph's, and Ministry Enrichment Gathering on Saturday, November 9th, 2024, from 9:30 a.m. to 3 p.m. at St. Michael's. The topic for the gathering is Anointed for Mission and will be presented by Rachel Espinoza and Timothy A. Johnston of LTP of Chicago, Illinois. We are all anointed for mission and are called to exercise our baptismal call. At our baptism, each of us have been anointed as priest, prophet, and king. We have been empowered to carry out the mission of the entire people of God in the church and in the world. Let us all come together where we will explore our essential role in this mission, reflect on our unique gifts, and awake a renewed commitment to service in the church and in the world. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is calling all of us to awaken, come alive, and live out our baptismal call. Please mark your calendar for Saturday, November 9th, 2024, and pre-register. The deadline for registration is Friday, November 1st, 2024. Check the bulletin for the date and times. Also, you should have received a pamphlet with the registration form attached. If not, there are forms available in your church, or you may contact one of the team members. You may also find out how and where to pre-register in the bulletin. Thank you, and may God bless us as we renew our commitment to service in the church and in the world.
Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sandy. And so also, I add my encouragement to, if you haven't already, sign up for that. Everybody was mailed a brochure with a registration attached. You can get right on that and do that, or in online, or fill that out and get that back to us. We really need to know soon, so we need to let them know as far as the number of packets and information to bring, and of course, arranging for the food. So if you know that you're going to that, please register soon if you can. And I think of that, you know, we've done different things over the years. We've had like men's retreats. Last year we had Dr. Ray Guarendi here. A number of men from the whole area came. We've had women's, we've had married couples. So this is another opportunity just to come together and be enriched and inspired in our faith. Something I think we all need and long for. So it's a great opportunity right here in Hicksville, Ohio. A couple other announcements. So this Friday, November 1st, is the feast day of All Saints, a holy day of obligation. So you can see the mass schedule in the bulletin. There's a Thursday evening mass here, and then Friday all day long. So remember, with football games and things like that on Friday night, plan accordingly. It's still a holy day of obligation. We have that serious duty to attend mass on those days. And then with that being on Friday, so Thursday morning there will not be the regular school mass, but the school will be over here, the students doing a living rosary. So all are invited to that. That will take place Thursday morning at 8:30. So join the school community as they pray together the rosary. And then also a reminder that now as we will enter into November, the Saturday 4 o'clock mass will be at St. Michael in Hicksville. And finally, our RCIA classes begin today. So if you know of anybody that's interested, come on over invite them, or they can still let us know, but it'll start today at 10 o'clock. So you got time after Mass to get a donut and visit a little bit, and then they'll meet in the parish office, the center. So anybody who maybe is interested in learning about our Catholic faith certainly is welcome. The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do you, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the divine power, thrust into hell Satan and all the other evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our closing hymn is number 469, Hail to the Lord's Anointed, number 469.